Hey everybody, Automator here, and I'm going to try to answer a question I get asked over and over and over again, is what's the difference between an editor build and a regular legit in-game drop build? And I got the perfect way, I think, to show you. This is a Trickster build I've been working on, and it sucks. This is my absolute worst pet character. My rating system is, to be best in game, it has to have at least 7 minutes left on the clock at the end of a Shattered Realm 90 solo. This one gets maybe a 5. By far my worst pet character. I am going to show you how this performs with legit in-game drops, and then I'm going to compare it to a build, the number one Trickster build. And except for I did not use any editor. I don't own an editor. I didn't use an editor, so it's all in-game drops on that Trickster. So you're going to see the difference between this pet build and a non-pet build, and you're going to see the difference between how the non-pet build performs compared to the editor version. So I hope I made that clear. I'm just trying to answer questions, and if there's anything else I can think of, the only comment, I don't care if you use an editor or not. It's however you have the fun in the game, that's up to you. Well, I gotta pay attention to what I'm doing here. Whatever makes the game fun for you, more power to you. Absolutely have no issues with that whatsoever. The only time I might have an issue, and that's a strong might, but it doesn't bother me, is if someone posts a build and they make claims like what boss it can beat and how fast, and they use an editor to build it and they don't tell people that. They say this is a build guide, and then so somebody new to the game will follow a build guide and they'll have all the same stuff after way too much time farming, and they'll go, what's wrong? I got exactly what they had, but it's not even remotely close to as good. Because they used an editor, they should. If you use an editor to do a build, I mean, just for the sake of the new people, you should say you used an editor. You know, this gear does not reflect what you're going to find in the game. This is decency. All my builds are in-game drops. Some are pretty good. None of them are flawless. A lot of them are really, really bad. Like this belt right here. I always say it's the MI you need, not, and the prefix and the suffix can change. You can upgrade. This one's not even that. It's not even a good MI. It's just the only thing on this is 1 to all skills in Nightblade. Mighty doesn't help me. Untamed doesn't help me. It's a terrible belt. It's just the best that I have so far in game. So if you follow one of my builds, you're gonna do as good as I say the build is. That's how it's gonna be when you put, even if you put junk gear on it, it'll be the same. So you probably don't have to finish this. I think you get a pretty good idea by the progress we're making, and that I'm not dying, that we're gonna complete this. Well, here's a boss. We'll kill this boss with this terrible character. Oh, I'm short of wind devil. Let's get that summoned. So you can see that, yeah, this, I'm not gonna die. I'm gonna beat the end of the game, but there just won't be much time left on the clock. So I'm not gonna post this. You don't have to worry about it. You won't see this. Oh, that's gonna hurt. No, not too bad. So I'll kill him, and then I will load the character that is a legit version of the best build, as close as I can get it. Alright, so let's do that. Alright, with the Trickster, which is a copy of the number one build, so, and not everything exactly the same. They wanted these soul select light guards, but I looked at them and they were only for the resistances, so I substituted with the best that I happen to have, which I think is actually a little bit better. It's got insight on it. It's a little bit better than the ones they had, I think, with the resistances. But everything else is pretty close to what they had. Very close. The gear, every time I... Well, for a long time, for like a couple years anyway, when I would do Shattered Realms, when I found another one of these, I would compare it to the one I had. So these are better than what's going to drop. Chances are it's going to be better than what drops in the game normally. Because this one I probably replaced 4 times, these gloves, with something that was just a little tiny bit better. So I would say this is about as close as a match to that as possible with legit in-game gear. And I adjusted resistances accordingly to where my gear was slightly different than theirs, so we got the same resistances. This is essentially the same build. Let's see how this performs in a Shattered Realm. 90. Legit. Let's see. Summon Wind Devils. And I got this Trickster build off of Crate Form, number one build. And yeah, so let's check it out in a Shattered Realm 90. Legit melee character. And this is how everyone... Now you can have characters that can survive Shattered Realm 90, but then don't do any damage. This one does really good damage, but I can tell you right now, when we run into our first boss challenge, we're pretty much dead. But we'll see. Right now we're going to have probably a real good clock. We're just clobbering these guys. Just really good damage. Way better than my Trickster, that's for sure. Not nearly as good as my best character, pet character. Not even close, but... And here's our first boss. So are we going to... No, look at my health. I've popped my Aether Cluster. Can't take him. Maybe if I try to run and hide, but every non-pet character I've ever built is played exactly like this in a Shattered Realm 90. That is just the way it rolls. The advantage of pet character is they take the hits, not you. Yeah, like I said, you can build a tank where you can beat a Shattered Realm 90 and have like 3 minutes, 2 minutes, no minutes left on the clock. That's not what I consider best in-game build. So I hope this answered all those questions about editors. It's a night and day difference. If you use an editor, please don't think I'm mad at you. I absolutely have no problem with that. Just do whatever you enjoy. But if I say my build is a non-editor build, don't jump on me. I'm just making a statement of fact that, hey, I didn't use an editor to make this, so if you copy my build, if you do a pet MI run and you find, this isn't a good example, this is because this isn't my character. Okay, so if you do a pet MI run, the first MI that drops and you put that on your character and you follow the build that I have, you're going to do just as good as me. Maybe not as good because I got better gear, but I mean you're going to clear a Shattered Realm 90. I guarantee it. Hope this helps, and to stop those repeating questions I get over and over again, and I appreciate you listening to my answer on that, and I will see you later.